We'd like to talk to you about AP Biology. We don't study for anything.
Nope, not at all.
Don't do our homework, don't do any of the videos.
Nothing.
And we probably didn't even do that good in the class, if we wanted to be honest with you.
Yep. So, we're going to tell you all about how we failed.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Paul.
I'm Nate.
And we're going to tell you how we passed AP Biology.
We actually studied.
The best ways to complete homework?
And especially the best ways to learn from the homework?
It's just not do it. Paul, how are we going to do homework?
We're going to do it the night we get it, so it's all done, and you got to study it every day till the test.
Best way to manage reading and studying? How to understand the textbook?
We got a textbook?
I didn't know we got a textbook.
Wait, what were we talking about again?
The textbook.
So what you're going to want to do with the textbook is you got to read it, analyze it, memorize it up there so you can use it on the test.
Because you can't use it on the test.
How to manage time commitment, especially with other demanding classes, when extracurriculars get busy.
Wait till the last minute.
Just due tomorrow means due tomorrow.
So if you want to manage time with your schoolwork and sports and other jobs and stuff like that, you just gotta
don't sleep.
And what non-mandatory work did we do?
None. It's not mandatory.
It's not mandatory. We're not doing it. Simple as that.
With mandatory work, you gotta do all of it. Anything you're supposed to do in the classroom. Bozeman videos, Quizlets, anything.
How to study for quizzes and tests.
Just do it right before the test. You'll figure it out. It's fresh on your mind.
Skim it a couple of times and just pray that you remember it.
You got this.
When you study for tests and quizzes, you just gotta go over those notes that she gave you, everything she gave you.
Book, Quizlet, Bozeman videos, any resources you can.
And just memorize it, keep it fresh.
Taking quizzes and tests.
Sit next to someone smart.
Like Nate, Paul.
Study for it. So.
They actually study, and
it helps.
I mean, I'm busy.
I ain't got time.
In taking tests, you want to really focus and use your time management skills. So, like, if one of the answers doesn't look correct, cross it out so you have, like, process of elimination. And if you don't know the answer to a question at all, just skip over it and come back to it if you have time. And if you don't have time at all, just bubble in.
So, how do you do labs, projects, and other long assignments, and how do you fit in the time?
Just don't do them.
I mean, labs, pointless. Projects, pointless. Reading, pointless. So, my advice is, go home, take you a good nap, eat, then just
let your group members do the labs.
You're in a group for a reason. Let them take some of it.
What do you want to learn, let them do it.
Yeah, take people like Nate and Paul.
Projects and other long assignments, all you need to do is just pay attention. And whenever as soon as you get there, you start on it. You don't play around.
Albert I.O., how to successfully answer the questions.
Let Nate and Paul do them first.
Let Nate and Paul do it, and then you just hit one of these. You just see their answers.
The second to last one.
And then you just kind of winging, like everything else you do in the class. Winging.
When working on Albert I.O.'s, you're going to want to like really analyze the question, really get deep in there. And if you don't know the answer, just, you know, take a gamble. You know? And if you don't get it right, then see what it says the correct answer is and why that's the correct answer. And if you don't get a good grade, that's fine. It won't hurt your grade at all.
Stop that CO5 book. Did you really use it? Could you have done more in it? Recommend for next year? No, I do not recommend it. Kate didn't even buy the book.
I did buy the book. It just never came here.
He bought the wrong book twice. And we never used it. I actually bought mine and opened it up maybe twice. And yeah.
We're not supposed to be telling the truth right now.
5 Steps to a 5 book is really important because they have a practice exam at the beginning of it, so you know where you're placing. Tell you if you got a 5, 4, 3, 2, or 1. And if you actually bought the 5 Steps to a 5 book, you should be set.
How did we study for the AP exam itself? We didn't do it. We didn't study. Why would we study? Doesn't it count towards our grade? I mean, we took the AP class, but I mean, if I don't get the credit, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's all right.
In studying for the AP exam, you're going to want to, there's a bunch of practice tests out online, just go over those and go over all the information you have for the book, 5 Steps to a 5, notes.
Hit them with that boom dynamite. Oh, yeah.
Nate's a director here.
Just skim over it once or twice.
We're gonna throw a shout out to Sonny.
Say, read!
Nate, where are you?
30.
Nate, you said.
That's a really clumsy.
It is.
Ah,
shake it.
I swear to God, if you touch me one more time, I can't say that.
Go.
Hi,
I'm Paul.
I'm Nate.
I got you.
I got you. Hold on.
I got you.
Get up.
Let me do it. I got
you. Act.
Hi, I'm Paul.
Kate, there goes your girl.
There she goes, Kate.
There comes.
That's good, that's good.
Hey Kate,
is it hard to focus now?
I don't know.
Okay, Quizlet, look at the book in the video.
Read the book, there you go.
Take notes on the book.
I didn't study all year.
Nobody did, that's why we had the great
thing. I think Paul did.
Okay.
Alright, Albert Ayo, how to successfully answer the question.
You already did Albert Ayo.
Oh. Stop Steps to a 5 book. Did you really use it?
Did you really?
Yeah, I really bought it.
I
never used it.
He really
bought it twice and did not. Yeah.
Next.
Okay.
What?
Come on, dude.
Hey, what'd you say, boy?
Hey, boy.
I'm working on Albert Ayo.
Okay, you want to do this by yourself?
Okay, we need some photo shoots.
Nate Dog!
Every time I do it on myself, I get garbled tongue. Mm.
Are you still recording?
Yep. Do you want to blip a reel?